Hello everyone, here we are again in the living room for a new workout. For this new workout series, I thought we are going to use equipment that more or less maybe most of you have at home or can subsidize with something. So we start our series with the step. So everyone most probably has already seen a step. Most people maybe have a step at home or can use stairs in their backyard or wherever. So I thought very often we have this equipment at home and we don't really know how to use it. I mean, we know on a step I can step up, I can step it down. But how do I build a whole workout around a stepper so that at the end of the workout I have used my entire body and I have done a full body workout? So this is what we are going to do today. As you can see, I have the step on the highest level, which I find is for the exercises that I've picked the best for. So go get your step out of the garage or wherever it is, and then we will go for our workout. As always, I will be showing variations for the different movements, so you can pick your variation and then go for the circuit training. Enjoy!
So, and then let's dive right into it. Stand in front of your step, put your heel onto the step and have your knee all the way straight, leaning your upper body straight to the front. As you lean to the front, make sure your upper body really stays straight and ensure that you're always looking forward. The moment you start looking down, your spine will round, so you want to really keep looking forward to get the maximum stretch over your back. You don't have to hold the position for too long, as we want to kind of warm up more dynamic, and just keep switching legs, hold for like 1 second, and then we move on to the next exercise. So standing, and then you put one foot onto the step and you shift forward, having the back leg on the floor and also keeping the back knee as straight as possible while the front knee bends. Make sure that the front knee stays in one line with your ankle. So you don't want the knee to go too much out, too much in, but you want the knee to kind of shift right above the toes. Again, here I'm looking all the way to the front and my knee is pushing all the way forward, because we want to move and mobilize the ankle and the knee joint at the same time. Here, if you have a lower step, you get less kind of flexing in the ankles and in the knee. If the step is high, like in my case, the knee and the ankle are bending a bit more. Also, keep the speed again a little bit on the faster side to keep the dynamic going. Then we go for our next exercise. You go into a high plank. And then you rotate your hand as much back and up as you can. You can also, when you have the feeling, this is a little bit too much for me, just bend the elbow and not rotate as much. Otherwise, you really want to try to stretch all the way up to the ceiling. Have your hip to the front and your hip and your upper body in one long straight line. And then keep going, keep shifting right and left. And always make sure that your hands, your fingers are straight and open, and you keep looking up towards the ceiling. Remember, always the rest of your back goes where your eyes go. So when you look down, your upper body will never turn as much as you could turn when you look up at the ceiling. And here we go for our next movement. So we just stand sideways next to the step, a little bit further away, and you put one foot onto the step and then bend the knee. So here also I make sure that my knee and my foot stay in one line. So I lean sideways and then I bend the knee. And because the leg is a little bit up, the position is a bit awkward, and I warm up the hip in a different way than when I would just kind of stand on the floor. Let's change the leg. So come to the other side, put your foot onto the step, make sure knee and foot stay in one line, and bend your knee as much as you can. Lean your upper body to the front, push your hip to the back so that your spine stays long and straight again, and keep going up and down. Also here, we don't want to stay too long in one position. And then we come to our next movement. Again, we go to a plank on the step, and then you want to go into a kind of like downward dog caterpillar movement. So I walk with my feet close to the step, then I drop the hip all the way down and I look forward and up at the ceiling. And then I walk with my legs front and down. I keep the knees as straight as possible. I do small and fast steps. And again, walking all the way to the front, knees stay straight, hip pushes back and up. And again, I repeat myself, you want to not rest in one movement, in one position for too long, because we want to keep moving since this is supposed to prepare us for our workout that is about to come. So keep going one more time, front and up, and then we move on to the next movement. The next movement starts well. We just sit on the step. So this is a nice position to get started. Unfortunately, then we have to kind of lift the hip up, and now we just bring the hip, the feet front and back. You want to make sure your hip stays as much up as possible, and your knees really stretch out as much as you can. Your chest stays forward. You don't want to round the shoulders. And keeping the hip up, keeping the chest forward, you stretch your legs out one at a time and really push yourself front and up and keep looking forward, keep smiling happily, and make sure you always lift your feet as you come back so you don't want to drag them over the floor. And keep going for a little longer, and then we move again on to our next movement. And then this is a step over the step. So I'm going from here, just step over the step lengthwise, and then step back. So this is just a little bit of coordination, just to get to know how wide is the step actually, how long do I have to step, how high is it. And you can play with the speed here a little bit. You can go slower, you can go faster. And I can tell you, this is also the last exercise here of our warm-up. And then we go straight into our circuit training. So keep stepping front and back. Make sure you are safe. So make sure you have enough space when you take the feet back and you don't kind of hang under the step. And keep going a little bit longer, and then we are almost done. And then in the when we go right into me showing you the exercises, so you just kind of do the exercises with me so that we will not lose all this warm-up work that we just did. So our first exercise in this circuit training will be a step up. So you step one foot onto the step and then you lift your leg. So you can do it either as I've shown here, not going too much down, or you can bring the knee all the way on the ground and then lift all the way up. Our second movement here in the circuit training is a classic push-up. The step here on the makes the push-up a little bit easier. Now, also, the more you take your feet outside, the easier the push-up becomes. So I place my hand onto the step. I make sure hip and upper body are straight, and then I bring my upper body and my hip as much down towards the step as I can. You do not want to drop the hip, so you want to make sure that your hip and your upper body stay in one long straight line. If this is too easy for you, you can make this whole thing more difficult by putting your feet on the step instead of your hands and then try to go down from there. Also here, you want to keep your hip and your upper body in one long straight line and not drop the hip. Okay, and then we move on to our next movement in the circuit. This is a hip hinge. So for here, you can sit first on the step and then you bring the hip to the front and you drop the hip all the way down on the floor and you lift it all the way front and up. If you say, "Yo, this is easy," you can each time you come up, lift one leg high up and do this whole thing a bit faster. And then we move on to our next movement. This is the side step. So you stand sideways next to your step and you just put one foot on the step, the second foot on the step, and just kind of step sideways over. Or if you want to do this whole thing a bit more difficult, you go faster. Make sure your toes always point to the front, or you go really fast and then you only have one foot on the step at the time. And you can really kick it here. Just make sure you put the foot in the center so the step doesn't fall. So the next one you might know already from my previous workouts. It's like one of my favorite movements. It's the picking something from the ground. So you stand with your back to the step and you just bend your legs and put both hands on your knee. Or You stand and you put both hands on the floor and come up and down, pushing with your leg through to the ground, or you come up into a high plank, lift the foot up off the step, and then come with the same leg back onto the step, high plank, take the leg to the front again and come again back and up. Okay, for our next movement, we can sit. So you put your hands onto the step, you sit down on the step, and you come with your hip forward. Now you want to push both your elbows backwards. You want to make sure you don't drop your hip all the way, but you want to really just push the elbows backwards, and the hip just basically goes down because the elbows bend a little bit, but make sure the main action is coming from the arms. Okay, and then we come for a side squat. This is similar to what we did in the warm-up, only this time we do squats. So you have for the squat one leg on the step, and you can vary how deep you go down. So you can either do the squat very flat or go deep down, or you can even lift one leg up as you come up. Make sure your knee points to the front. And then we come to our last exercise. So here you want to just kind of climb stairs. So you put right foot, left foot, right foot, left foot, right up, right down, left down. You can go as fast as you can. In the second round, we do the other leg. So, and here you have all the exercises in all their glory. Get ready. You know how it works. 45 seconds exercise, 20 second a break. And then get ready for the step lunge. And stand facing your step. And then get ready, steady, and go. So one foot, the right foot comes onto the step, and you pick your variation of how much you want to go down. You remember all the things that are important about the step lunge. So you want to go as much down as you think is good for you, and then have one knee, as you have the front knee, the one that is on the step, in one line with your ankle, and just go up and down. Remember to always look forward to the front. Keep your upper body straight. Use your arms to go up and down so that they also get some action here. Also, it's much easier to lift when you use your arms. Have your fingers open and keep going for a little bit longer. And then 3, 2, 1, and done. And we go directly into our next exercise, which is then again the push-up. So you can get ready already. Either you put your hands in front of the step and your feet onto the step, or you put your hands onto the step. Remember, you never want to drop your hip and bend your arms, only as much as you can keep hip and upper body one line. 3, 2, 1, and go. So feet, I put here my feet onto the step, and then you go. So your first priority is, of course, to keep the hip and the upper body in one line. If you look at me in the video, I really don't have a lot of power in my arms. I am working on that. I promise. But really make sure you only go down as much as you can, control your hip, rather push your hip a little bit more up than having it hang as you come all the way down, and try go a little bit longer and keep going. And we have only a few seconds left, and then again 3, 2, 1, and break. And then we get ready for our next movement. The nice thing is, in preparation time, you can just sit on the step. So sit on your step, have your feet in front on the ground, put your hands onto the edge of the step, and then we get ready to lift the hip. Either just lift the hip or bring your leg up. 3, 2, 1, and then go. So from here, you bring your hip up and down, your elbows go back, and you can either lift your leg with the hip, or you just keep the legs on the ground and really try to do the movement very powerful and just pushing up and down, and really try to focus on pushing the hip up. So you not only want to kind of stretch the legs a little bit, but you really want to focus on pushing the hip high up. Ideally, your hip and your upper body are like in one long straight line. If you lift the feet, make sure the feet come on the ground softly and you don't make too much noise. And a little bit longer. 3, 2, 1, and stop. And then we go get ready for the side step. So you want to stand sideways parallel to your step. Remember, you can either just step over the step, or like change hopping, so you only have one leg on the step. So get ready, and then we go 3, 2, 1, and go. So sideways, and either we hop or we go one foot. It doesn't matter. Pick your variation. You can also take a slower variation now. And when you find, this is actually doable very well, in the second round, we have two more rounds to go. You can go much faster than this. So please feel free. Also, you can start fast and then get slower. This is really up to you. Just make sure you land softly. Make sure you land in the center of your step so that you don't trip the step over, because this would not be so ideal. So a little bit longer. And 3, 2, 1, and so, and here we are again with my favorite exercise, picking something off the ground. So you want to stand with your back to the step and then put one foot, the right foot, onto the step for the time being. So put the right foot onto the step, stand on your left leg, and remember, you want to bend your left leg now, and either put the hands onto the ground, come into a plank, or just put the hands onto your knee. And if you go down, make sure you go for a nice plank, hip, upper body, one line, and then the same leg. So the left leg comes again to the front while the right leg is on the step. And nice planks in between if you go for a plank. Otherwise, just bend and stretch the leg and touch the ground if you want. So keep going, always the same leg. In the second round, we do the other leg. And go slow. This is a movement that is not about speed, but about balance and coordination. So don't rush it. And go a little bit more. 3, 2, 1, and done. Okay, and then we go for our tricep dips. So here again, good news. You can sit on your step and just get ready. So you hold the edge of the step and then you bring your hip front and up, and we go from here, bending the elbows back and go. So the elbows are bending, and remember, you don't want to come with the hip too much down. You want to keep the hip, yeah, not up, but you know, it should not be kind of the focus of the movement. You want to focus on pushing the elbows back as much as you can, and the shoulders go back, the chest goes front. And you really want to feel this at the back of your arms. Make sure the shoulders are not coming too much front. And keep looking forward. Don't look too much down so that your spine doesn't start rounding. Keep your chest forward so that the distance between the two shoulders stays wide. And work your elbows to the back as much as you can. So, and again, we have few movements. 3, 2, 1, and break. Okay, then we go for the side squat. So this is the squat with one leg on the step where you can either lift the leg or not. So get ready, stand again sideways towards the step, put one foot, the right foot, onto the step, and then in 3 seconds you go. So 3, 2, 1, and off you go into a squat. If you want, you lift the leg. If not, you just keep your foot on the step and go up and down into a squat. Upper body stays long and straight, and you want to push your hip back and lean your upper body a bit to the front. Make sure your knees keep pointing forward. Your foot might be a little bit turned out on the step, and either you lift the left leg up or you just keep the feet on the ground. Keep going. You want a nice speed here, so you don't want to go too slow. And keep going up and down and up and down. Very nice. And few more movements. 3, 2, 1, and done. So, and then we come to our last movement here. So stand in front of your step. Remember, this is the fast stepping up and down. So very simple. We start with the right foot and you go right, left, right, left. So right foot up, left foot up, right foot down, left foot down. So get ready. And then we have 3 seconds, 2, 1, and go. And right and left and right and left, up and down. Stand in the center of the spot, of the step all the time. Land softly and make sure the step doesn't trip. And keep going. Use right hand, left leg, going forward and back. Now, the more you can use your arms here, the better, because it helps you to step powerful onto your step. And but pick your speed. If you prefer to go a little bit slower, you just take it a little bit easier here. Otherwise, you really go for it. Imagine you are missing your last train and you have to run up these stairs to the track and keep going a little bit longer and go 3, 2, 1, and then you are done. Go for a long break, grab some water, and then we do the whole thing again. Now, the good thing is that you know which movements are coming up, so you can really focus on giving them a good form and doing as many repetitions as you can with a nice form. So get ready, stand in front of your step because the first movement that is about to come up is the step lunge again. So now we put the left foot onto the step. And then you want to bend your right knee as much back and down as you can and lift front and up. So get ready and 3, 2, 1 and go. Okay, so now left foot is on the step and you want to lift front and up, and either you don't go too much down or you really try to almost touch with the knee the ground. Yeah, to keep it like 1 centimeter above ground, keep your upper body forward. Remember, you want to keep looking to the front, but remember also, you know the movement now, so maybe you can focus on going a little bit faster. Although, for most of us, the left side is a little bit weaker side, so we might have more problems with the balance. Make sure your knee points forward and is in one line with your foot all the time, and keep going for a little bit longer and go, 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 go. 3, 2, 1, and. And then we are off for our next movement, which is the push-up. So again, decide if you want to put your hands onto the step or if you want to put the feet onto the step. The step in between would be to have the hands on the ground, no? So hands on the step is a little bit easier. Hands on the ground is the most difficult. So 3, 2, 1, and go. And then hands onto the step or feet onto the step. Remember, hip and upper body stay in one long line. Pull your belly button towards your spine, kind of round your back a little bit. Yeah, I'm not saying really rounding, but just kind of push the hip a bit more up than you actually think would be good. And keep the knee straight. Imagine your kneecaps want to kind of push through your legs. And then keep pushing the elbows outside for a little bit longer and keep going. Yeah, the head turns red. You might be sweating, but this is all good. And go 3, 2, 1, and take a break. So, and then we come for the hip hinge again. So, this is again the good news. You can again sit on the step. So, sit on the step, have your hands on the edges of the step, and then get ready to lift the hip up. Remember, you can lift one leg if you want. 3, 2, 1, and go. So from here, sit on the step, and then your hip goes back, and you lift the hip up as much as you can, and go up and down, and up and down as fast as you can. Up and down, and really remember to push the hip all the way up and keep going and going. I'm a little bit sleeping here. No, I stayed a little bit too long, and keep going more up and down, and then 3, 2, 1, and back. So, and then we go for the side step. So stand next to the step and get ready to either step with both feet onto the step or to change right and left. So a few more seconds break and then 3, 2, 1 and go. So lift one foot onto the step and then right and left, up and down as fast as you can. And as fast as you want, so either with a hop or you just step very quickly, make sure your toes point to the front, knees and upper body are in one line, and you keep going up and down and up and down, landing softly here. Make sure the step doesn't trip over and keep stepping sideways in order to have this lateral action and train the gluteus medius on the side, and keep going for a little bit more. Sideways and sideways and sideways. So either step with both feet or hop only one foot. 3, 2, 1, and break. And then we go for our next movement where we just have one foot on the step, which will be the left foot this time. So have the left foot on the step, stand facing away from the step, and then you want to either bend your knee, put the hands on the ground, or go into a high plank. So get ready and go. Hands onto the ground, step with your feet back, then take your right foot to the front and come again up into a standing. And then again, hands onto the ground or hands onto the knee, just going up and down. Go up and down, lift the leg or keep it on the step. So find your variation. Either you do the same that you did before, or you try a little bit more tricky or a little bit more easier. Sometimes it's also a nice variation to kind of start in the first round a bit more tricky and then make it a bit more easier as you get more and more tired. So a little bit longer here, keep going. And down and up and down and up. 2, 1, and break. And then, yay us, we can go for a sitting again. So sit on your step and just take a little rest and grab your edges of the step and then bring your hip already up. We want to go for the triceps movement and get ready to go. And 3, 2, 1. And then sit on the step and bring the hip to the front and push the elbows to the back. And again, remember, not the hip is here the main player, but the arms. So you really want to focus on pushing the elbows back as much as you can. Keep looking to the front and go. You can either do long movements where you focus on going as much down as you can, or you can do very short, like pulses. This is also a nice variation. So go like up and down, pulsing, doing, 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 doing. This could also be a nice variation in this round. And keep going a little bit longer. We are almost there. Keep going, keep going, keep going. And then 3, 2, 1, and break. And then we go for the side squat. So this time the left foot comes on to the step. And you want to stand sideways next to the step. So stay, get ready, put your left foot onto the step, and then we go 3, 2, 1, and go. So go down into a squat and the leg comes either up or you just go into the squat. Focus on pushing your hip to the back, having your upper body long and straight, having the knees pointing to the front, having the feet kind of parallel as much as it's possible since they are not on the same level. Keep going up and down. You can also here play a little bit with the speed. So go faster or go slower and deeper down. And keep going and keep going a little bit longer. And go, 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 go. And then we have like, again, only a few more seconds to go. We'll see if you can do maybe 3 more repetitions. 3, 2, 1, and break. Okay, and then our last movement in this round. So you want to go as fast and possible as possible up and down the step. This time we start with the left leg first. So get ready, stand in front of your step, and then get the left foot ready. 3, 2, 1, and go. Up and down as quickly as possible. Again, landing in the center of the step, going with your arms front and up, lean maybe your upper body a little bit forward, and keep going up and down as quickly as possible. Zaka, 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 zaka. And then we are already like halfway through, and you want to go more, you want to go more, and keep going. Try to keep the speed from the beginning. And go. Remember, we have to do this round only one more time, so you're already more than halfway through. This is great news here. And go a little bit more and keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going. 2, 1, and break. So really good, well done. We have one more round to go. So now in this round, all the exercises that require one leg only, we will kind of change midway so that both legs get the same kind of workout. If you have the feeling there is a big difference between both legs, You could also kind of train the weaker side again. So we start as only the weaker side. So we start now with the step lunge. You put your right foot on the step first. So stand in front of your step. And then remember, this is the last round. Say goodbye to every exercise after we are done. And put your right foot onto the step. Put the left knee almost onto the ground and go. Our last 45 seconds for this exercise have started. So keep going up and down and up and down and keep going a bit more. And soon we can change. 3, 2, and 1. Change legs. Put the left foot onto the step and keep going up and down more. And go and go and keep the upper body straight. And the opposite arm always comes to the front. And then keep going, and you are almost there, you are almost there, a little bit more, and then you can say goodbye to the exercise. 2, 1, and break. Our last rounds of push-ups. So again, pick either hands on the step or hands on the floor, and then you want to make your knees all the way straight, and you remember again, you want to keep your hip and your upper body in one long straight line. So then from here, you keep everything straight and then you go front and down and back and up. So keep going, hip, upper body, one line, and keep pulling your belly button towards the spine. Have the elbows come out. Don't drop the head too much. Remember also, this one is the last movement. We are not going to do this again. So enjoy it a bit more. Remember, this gives you at some point in your life strong arms. So go up and down, make the legs straight, push the knees back, and keep going up and down for a little longer. We are almost, really almost at the finish line. And then go 3, 2, 1, and break. So again, sitting on the step. So sit down, make yourself comfortable. Hold the edges of the step. Also remember, this is the last time we are going to train the glutes and hamstrings here in this way. So enjoy it. And then get the hip up and we go. 3, 2, 1, and go. So hip goes up, hip goes down. If you want, you lift the leg with this movement and you keep going. And remember to push the hip all the way up to have the shoulders down, the chest comes forward, and you keep going. Also, here we are almost halfway through now. Yeah, no, we are more halfway. Now we are halfway through. So keep going and up and down and kick the leg up and put it silent on the ground. Don't let it just drop, but put it silently on the ground. And then you want to go more, go more, go more. And then the last movement, last seconds have started. 2, 1, and break. So then sidestep. So here you remember you want to just kind of jump over the step as quickly as you can. So get ready, sit then sideways to your step and then go change as quickly as possible. So go and 3, 2, 1, and go. So 1 foot on the step and then right and left as quickly as you can and keep going right and left, pushing the hip to the back, having the shoulders down, and then go right and left down and keep going, keep going, keep going, either both feet or one, and go, 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 go. This is also the last time we are going up and down the step as quickly as possible. So be ready to say goodbye to this one as well. And go and go a little bit more. And almost there, almost there. And then we go 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and break. Yay, my favorite movement. One more time. So catch your breath for a second and then stand with your back to the step. Put your right foot on the step first and get ready to bend down and come up again. So 3, 2, 1, and go. So go all the way down, having your legs straight and then coming front and up. And then go again down. Leg straight, hip, upper body, one line, and then come up And go for a few more times, or one more time on this side, down and up. And then switch sides. So take the other leg, take your left foot onto the step and have your right foot on the ground and keep going a bit more. And then you can almost say goodbye to this one. And then we are also more than halfway through with our workout here. And keep going a little bit longer, like one more repetition most probably. And down and 3, 2, 1 and break. Okay, so again, you can sit on the step. How nice is that? Grab the edges of the step and remember this time not the hip is the star but the elbows. So you want to bring the elbows as much back as you can. So last time this one as well. So and go 3, 2, 1. 1 and off you go. So sitting and then the elbows go back and the hip stays more or less where it is. And you push the elbows back, you keep your chest in the front. And then you keep going and going and going. And remember to keep a happy smile. These movements might be difficult, but they build nice arms for us. So we should enjoy them. So keep going a little bit more. You are more than halfway again. I keep repeating myself, but there is not much else to say than just tell you, okay, it is over soon. So go 3. More repetitions, 2, and then 1, and then we are off to side squats. So here for the side squat, again, we are going to work both legs here. So you put one foot onto the step, you go into a wide step, and then go get ready to go into a squat and either lift the leg or keep it on the floor. 2, 1, and go. So from here, go down into a squat and lift, go down into a squat and lift. Keep your knees pointing forward, keep your upper body long and straight. Lean to the front and get ready for a few more repetitions. And then you want to change to the other side. So go and go and go and then change legs. And then put the other foot on the step and get ready to go up and down and on the other side and keep going. And a bit more up and down and then again 3, 2, 1 and break. Yay, our last movement is here. So stand in front of the step. We start with our right leg now. And I will tell you when to change to the left side. So we just want to climb the step or go up and down the step, not climb the step, as quickly as you can. So go from here, 3, 2, 1, and go. And run up and down with the right leg first and keep going. And go, 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 as quickly as you can. You know the movement by now. You know there are no surprises coming. It's just up and down. And now switch feet. So the other foot starts, so the left foot is now on the step and you keep going up and down. Go a little bit longer, more, 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 and go up and down. And then we have only a few more repetitions to go. And then really you are done and you deserve a very long break. And keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going. And 3, 2, 1, and done.
That's it for a workout for this week. I hope you enjoyed. I hope you saw that with a stepper you can do more than just stepping up and down or using it as a shelf somewhere in your room. If you like what we are doing here, subscribe to my channel and give me a thumbs up and leave me in the comments what kind of equipment you maybe want to have a workout done with. I will see you next week.